Spend less time in the laundry room and more time doing the things you love. Introducing the Samsung Smart Top Load Laundry Pair, now available at Lowe's. The washer's large capacity means you can fit more in every load. Plus, its super speed setting washes a full load in only 28 minutes. Shop the smart washer that will streamline laundry day, backed by Lowe's Price Promise. Based on using super speed on a normal cycle with an 8-pound load, terms apply. See Lowe's.com/price promise for details. U.S. only.
Hey, Washington. Delta Dental is on a mission. Our state has a lot to smile about, and we think those smiles should be healthy and bright. That's why we support our Cora Foundation Smilemobile. This dental office on wheels provides checkups and oral health education to communities that need it most. The Smilemobile has reached over 44,000 children and families across Washington. See how the Smilemobile is getting us closer to a 100% cavity-free state at cavityfreewa.com.
Hey, this is BJ. Thanks for listening to our show's podcast. If you're a fan of all things geeky, you should check out my other podcast, BJ Shea's Geek Nation. We have new episodes every day, and you can check it out at bjgeeknation.com.
Your home is going into foreclosure, and you feel like a financial wreck. You don't know where to turn for accurate information. I'm bankruptcy attorney Travis Gagne. Let's talk about some legal options. If we work quickly, we can propose a plan to save your home, modify the loan, or in many cases, even eliminate your second mortgage. The consultation is free. I've helped hundreds of people just like you make informed decisions about whether to save their home or exit it on a reasonable, organized timeline. The chapter you choose sets the tone for the next chapter of your life. Please contact me today at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com.
KISW, the Rock of Seattle. All right, there's a Twitter video out there that millions of people have been viewing this thing. And I don't know. This woman is trying to pass off the fact that her cat actually talks. This is, and look, like me, a lot of these Twitter viewers are skeptical too. And I wear spectacles from time to time.
Oh, yeah. Huh.
But here's the thing, man. She basically is asking her cat what he's doing. And then the cat appears to respond, nothing. We'll see if you think, in fact, that's what this cat's saying.
Mikey, what are you doing? Nothing? I don't think it's nothing. I think you're trying to get into the cat drawer.
Totally said it. I told it, yeah.
Yeah, that was nothing.
Totally heard it. It said nothing.
Yeah.
And she even looked at her like, nothing. And also, I think she said that's the end of it, that my cat owner is crazy.
Yeah, she did say that too.
Rude.
Do you think your cats talk to you?
Oh, absolutely.
Like
100%.
Why are we asking him?
Yeah.
Because we know.
Because you need a cat owner to tell you that, yes, your cats can communicate with you through their meows.
Oh, really?
Yeah, also eye blinks too.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Is that a thing or you're just making
it up? No, it's legitimately a thing. Like if you ask a cat a question or if they're comfortable with you and they slow blink, it usually means an affirmative or at least that they're comfortable with you.
Oh, I had no idea that was a thing.
Let me check with my dog, Lulu. Oh, she thinks the rev's crazy.
No,
oh,
that yeah, sounds a little aggressive there.
Yeah.
So
I don't know if you heard it, but she said that.
We're going to play this again. And do we believe the cat's at least making that noise, or are people suspect that the cat's not even making the noise and she's just made her noise herself?
Well, it makes a noise that sounds like nothing, but I don't think it's saying nothing. Why are we even having this debate?
Well, because
it's not nothing.
Because Rev really seems to think the cat is actually saying nothing.
Mikey, what are you doing? Nothing? I don't think it's nothing. I think you're trying to get into the cat drawer.
Well, Mikey said nothing before she even asked. You know, she said Mikey, and then it went, So, I mean, it said it even before she, so.
Dude, I'm watching the video, and the person put captions on it, and when it went made that sound, it's saying that the cat said, hi, mom.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, it kind of sounds like Hi Mom, too.
Hi Mom or nothing. Okay, great. Yeah.
I heard Yandy.
Yeah, I heard Yanny.
Yanny.
Yeah.
Laurel.
Yeah.
Nothing.
Yeah, nothing. Okay. Well, congratulations to all of us.
You don't sound impressed there, BJ.
Well, millions of people have tried to figure this out, and I'm trying to figure out why they're trying to figure it out. I don't know. I guess people can believe that their animals will do whatever they want them to believe.
When you're cooped up in the house, you need to talk with anybody.
You know what's funny, though? It's like I'm watching like how we communicate with baby Tatum right now. Granted, not as...
Does she say nothing when you ask her things?
Not yet. She's clearly not as good of a speaker as a cat. But it's been a lot of fun just to see, like, the things that she gets excited, like, the way that she wants to communicate with us. She likes to, like, I'll give her a head nod, and she'll just nod back. And she has this look of such pride, like, yeah, we're talking.
Yes.
And it's super fun. Like, that to me has been, like, one of the most fun things about this whole watching her grow into a personality. That, and she likes to stick her tongue out and go, like that, and I do it right back to her.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
That one's pretty cool. And then she does that. So that's right now. Like,
that's
the
how
gods
she's
must
doing.
Be crazy back in the day.
Yeah. She might start now. Who sticks out the tongue first? Because at least according to the baby books, that she will now that she knows the tongue works, she will stick her tongue out and expect a response.
Oh, 100%.
Yeah.
100%. Like, she does that. As soon as she sees me, the tongue comes out. Like, she knows that that's dad's way of communicating
that's
with me.
That's awesome.
Yeah, that's it. And the head nod is awesome, too, because now you guys will be head nodding all over the house.
The head nod makes me melt every time because, like, she'll be, like, hanging out with mom and just doing something, and then she looks at me, and I give her the nod, and she nods back, and she just starts smiling like, yeah, Dad, what's up?
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
Spend less time in the laundry room and more time doing the things you love. Introducing the Samsung Smart Top Load Laundry Pair, now available at Lowe's. The washer's large capacity means you can fit more in every load. Plus, its super speed setting washes a full load in only 28 minutes. Shop the smart washer that will streamline laundry day, backed by Lowe's Price Promise. Based on using super speed on a normal cycle with an 8-pound load, terms apply. See Lowe's.com/price promise for details. U.S. only.
Everything is better electrified. Like the guitar, toothbrushes, or cars. And Hyundai has the widest range of electrified vehicles on the market, including the first ever Tucson and Santa Fe plug-in hybrid EVs. You can use electric when you want it or gas when you need it. It's your journey. Evolve it beyond the pump in the 2022 Tucson or Santa Fe plug-in hybrid EVs. Visit your nearest Hyundai dealer or learn more at HyundaiUSA.com. Call 562-314-4603 for complete details.
We all remember that one professor, the one everyone on campus had to take no matter what subject they taught because how much fun their class was. What if we told you there was a streaming service that had all those professors? One Day University has every must-have professor from the best colleges all across the country. One Day University, the most fun talks from the most fun professors. Available live and on demand. No homework, just the most fun you'll have while learning. Get a special offer at onedayu.com/odyssey.
99.9 KISW, the Rock of Seattle. Well, as you know, I'm a gym rat, so you know I got go-to songs when it comes to working out.
Getting swole with BJ.
So there was a survey done, and they asked people, okay, man, look, you know what? You're getting swole. What is your top go-to song when you're getting swole, doing the workout? And actually, it turned out to be a tie, a three-way tie for the top workout song for people.
One of these songs better be this, or it's not a real list. Come on, you can get your PR on that one, right, BJ?
Yeah. Is that pulse rate?
A personal record.
I was trying.
I was trying, right? I don't know.
I don't work out, so I was trying to go PR. Let me see if I can figure out what this means. Pulse rate, get your pulse rate up. I almost had it. All right, well, whatever. No, that wasn't surprisingly not in the top five, Stephen. Again, of course, in the top five, we have three tied for number one.
It's probably number six.
Yeah, I'm sure it's number 69, probably, in the don't ever play that song again category. Anybody have a favorite song when they work out? Maybe you'll hit one of these.
You know,
here we go. Is it Tay Tay?
No, okay. No. I need but for a brief period of time, I was listening to that WAP song every time I'd start in the gym. It would just kind of give me a little bit of a little swagger.
Damn.
But then I could see all the people at the gym, and I'm like, if they only knew, I'd probably be kicked out of the gym.
That's true. If somehow,
this is kind of awkward.
If somehow somebody Bluetoothed you.
What's up, ladies? You know what I'm listening to?
Yeah. Whoops.
Yeah. You want me to spot you?
Yeah, WAP is not not on here.
No, Megan Thee Stallion.
No wet-ass person is actually going to be on this list, even though you're sweating.
What about WAPR, wet-ass personal record?
Ah, that's number six. I will tell you this, they're all classic rock songs. I guess, they would all, I hate to say one of them does qualify for classic rock, but I think enough time has passed by that it does. One's definitely a pop rock song. The other one is probably pop rock, but it's a rock song. And then the other one's a real rock song.
which I'm very excited that they're in the top three.
What about the Bad Touch from the Bloodhound Gang?
That's the one.
Oh, hell yeah.
That's,
I'm going to listen to that next time I'm at the gym.
Steve Carell, Steve Carell's favorite person is in the top five.
Oh. Kelly Clarkson?
Yes, sir. Got the clue. I'll tell you that one. That's the number five one, Stronger by Kelly Clarkson. What doesn't kill you makes
you stronger. Stand on it. I don't think I knew this was her.
Yeah.
Oh, look at Steve. He's
for
pumping.
What, Jazzercise? Yeah. What is this?
Nothing wrong with Jazzercise. I used to do that.
Dude, I remember.
Of course
I could,
you did.
My dude, like, they have like that one room where you do like the dance aerobic music ones. I could totally hear that playing, and then every once in a while you'll just hear like a random like group of people going whoop whoop, and I'm like, what is happening in that room? Is it like a gathering of the juggalos? Like, I don't know what's going on.
Well, it depends on gathering. Yeah, you've seen some juggalos gathering.
Yeah, that's upbeat.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, it's, you know, I can see people, like Danny said, it's a good beat if you're doing any sort of aerobic stuff. Right?
I'm pretty much I'm just so basic when it comes to, like, I like the heavy, hard, like, rock music, like Hatebreed. A band called Madball seems to be my go-to that I go, like, whenever I'm at the gym or I need, like, some kind of energy, that's what I listen to. Because, like, every once in a while I'll try and listen to something that's not super heavy, and I'm like, man, I'm just not getting that maximum effort.
Yeah.
See, for me, since I don't really lift a lot, I'm doing more cardio type stuff. Like, I'll be on the tread, or I'll like go for a run outside. It's Superman by Goldfinger.
Okay.
Which is just very kind of, it's just because at that point I can run and beat with it, and it just kind of makes me feel like playing Tony Hawk's Pro Skater. Like, I'm, you know what I mean?
Takes you to a little like little fantasy world.
Yeah.
I'm going to give you a very lame ass clue to number four.
Number four. Okay.
Okay. You know, when you're working out, you sure as hell don't want any candy treats, so don't get lost trying to avoid them. How about that? That's the number four.
Huh?
When you're working out,
Monster Mash.
You do not want to have these candy treats. So don't get lost trying to avoid them.
Lost.
I just keep thinking of Hansel and Gretel, but I know that does not make
candy
sense.
Treats. Crunch, think of candy.
Crunch. Nestle's Crunch. I'm doing.
All right.
Oh,
well, stomach crunches.
Yeah, that would be a candy treat. But I did say treats because there's multiples of these that you like.
Was it at the candy shop? Remember that song?
Oh, yeah.
Going is that 50 Cent?
I mean, yeah, that's whoop, whoop, yeah, that would be whoop, whoop, that would be that would be what's his face? 50 Cent.
Yep.
Yeah, that's not it though.
No.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Again, I don't get lost.
Lost.
Trying to avoid these candy treats.
Beck loser.
Yeah, that's it. Beck is the greatest candy ever.
Beck's beer.
You know what? You don't want to get lost. Because you don't want these candy treats. They're really, the title is there, and also the artist is there. I've given you the title.
Okay.
Don't You Get Lost.
Don't You Get
candy
Lost.
Candy Treats. What musician has a name that sounds like candy?
Fun Dip.
Are you kidding me?
Mandy.
Mandy
Moore.
Mandy Moore.
Mandy Moore.
No,
missing You Like Candy.
Okay, I hate all of you.
What about vitamin C?
I think you guys know, and you're trolling me now, so I'm quitting the game. I'm quitting this game.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I actually really don't.
And one text says, BJ, you suck at giving clues.
Okay, really?
Oh, is it Eminem? Lose Yourself.
There we go. That person knows how to play games.
Next text, terrible clue, BJ.
That is not a terrible clue. Because candy treats, what musician is a name? I mean, Eminem. I mean, what the hell? Who's got? Is anybody named Baby Ruth? Is there anybody named whatchamacallit? No, but there is somebody.
If you would have said like chocolate candy treat, that would have helped.
Yeah, candy coated, maybe.
Well, I felt that would have been too much because how many musicians are named after a candy?
Yeah, text are coming. Eminem, lose yourself. Eminem, lose yourself.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah, that's the number four workout. Let's do it. Let's pump. Come on, Steve. Work it.
Work
get that
it.
PR up. Whatever that means.
Oh, jeez.
This would be good for, like, boxing.
Yeah.
Boxing.
I'm, like, listening to these. I'm like, the first one's Jazzercise. This one's, like, a boxing workout.
Mm-hmm. Wow. You guys are really hating
or
on the top
five. Or if
you're
eating spaghetti, your mom's spaghetti.
Yeah. That, too, yeah.
All right.
Yeah. Carving up for your next workout.
Yeah.
Look, man, if you want to thrive, you need to see your way through this one. There's my next clue. Okay.
These are bad.
They're tough.
Okay. You watch Supermarket Sweep where they do similar things like this, but they make sense.
You know what? Joe Exotic, this would probably be his favorite workout.
Oh, I the Tiger.
I the Tiger.
There we go.
There you go, you easy noobs. This is what you want, fine. This is tied for number one.
Yeah, I can see that.
Yeah, baby.
I love this song. Yeah. I'm sorry. Like, I remember when the new originals, we covered it for a half a second. We didn't do it very well, but I always look forward to playing it just because It's the greatest song ever written.
So is this just for running up the stairs? I mean, is this like for running?
Jumping jacks.
Okay.
Yeah, I feel like this is that's a good cardio song.
Yeah, yeah. Chasing chickens.
Or
yeah.
Even like jump rope. Mm-hmm. Could boxing in there. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All right, here's another one that's tied for number one. I'm going to give you a good clue for this one. Actor Rami Malek works out to this one.
All right, so it's Queen.
There we go. But
I was
not
thinking
give...
Mr. Robot.
Yeah, but now you're going to have to think of a Queen song that you think you would work out to.
Pretty good.
That's like end of the workout stretching.
Yeah. Another one bites the dust. I feel like this isn't going to get me in the mood.
Maybe a little more like We Are the Champions or something?
You know, you are close,
oh,
but...
We Will Rock You.
There we go.
Oh, yeah. Buddy, you're an old man, poor man, pleading with your eyes, gonna make you zombie someday. You got mud on your face, big disgrace.
Somebody better put your bag into your place. We will. I just want to watch Mighty Ducks now.
Nice.
Yeah,
stomp,
buddy.
Stomp, clap.
Mighty Ducks 2, sorry.
This one wouldn't really do much for me at the gym.
No, not a lot.
Stomp, stomp.
Yeah. I have to agree. I feel like, you know, when I'm hearing it going, all right.
Unless I was like a Stairmaster. Then I could time my beats to the song. Like
I can see what you're saying.
Step,
yeah.
Yeah. Sweat. Step.
All right,
sweat,
this sweat. Next one, definitely a core mega rock artist. We love the hell out of him here on The Rock. That's the tie for number one. No, that's not a clue.
Oh.
All right.
Oh,
I was trying. I was like, what, Stone Temple Pilots?
No, I'm not giving a clue. I'm just saying this is I might give a clue if I have to, but can you think of any, like, this is a big artist, classic. It probably can qualify classic rock now.
Wow.
Alice in Chains, Man in the Box.
That's a good one.
Good one, but no.
They always play it when the Seahawks score a touchdown.
Yeah. That's not it.
Chumbawamba.
Hell yeah.
We love that.
I'll give you a clue. It's not part of the Seattle sound, though there is a Seattle connection.
Motley Crue.
What's the Seattle connection with Motley Crue?
Mickey Six. Yeah. Grew up in Queen Anne.
I don't think, you know, you probably told me, and I think I forgot.
We've talked to him about it.
Yeah. Well, guess what? I did forget, and guess what? That's not the answer. All right, here's the thing. If you're in the Amazon.
Sir Mix-a-Lot.
Look, this is if you're working out in the Amazon.
If I'm doing glutes, I want to do Baby Got Back.
Hell yeah.
All right. I just gave you a clue, by the way.
In the Amazon.
Yeah, if you're in the Amazon.
Welcome to the jungle.
There we go, baby.
Oh, hey.
Yeah. I can see this one.
Yes, he's bopping it. Getting the PR going.
Getting that PR going.
That's he's doing it. Yeah, he's getting the HR going.
You know, there is I don't know if that I get kicked out of a gym if I do that.
That's a good point.
Oh, a different thing. I always, like, sometimes when I'm at the gym, I always wish I could, like, hit a button and know what someone else is listening to.
Oh, yeah.
Then they find out what you're listening to. What
is the problem? Like, there's been times where I'm like, I was listening to a new Miley Cyrus record at the gym, and I'm like, if they only knew, like, I'm like next to, like, and it's like, there's some dude that's just like, raw. And I'm like, he's probably listening to, like, Hatebreed or Slayer. And then I'm just jamming out to some Miley Cyrus song. It's so funny. Like, I think that'd be a fun thing to know what other people are listening. Like, there's a guy at our gym that just, all he does is dance. Yeah. Like, legit.
Yeah. Oh, sweet.
Be by the dumbbells. And he's just dancing. And he's got good moves. I never would think to ask, but my father-in-law just went up to him one time and goes, hey, what are you listening to? And the guy pulled out his phone and showed him, like, the music. It was, like, some crazy hip-hop mix of stuff. But it was just kind of funny that, like, you know, I would never think to bother somebody. I'll think it, but I would never, like, have that courage to just walk up to someone and be like, what are you listening to that's making you dance? Not even, like, he's not lifting any weights. He's just dancing.
But he's just dancing at the gym.
Every once in a while he'll do some kind of, like, you know, weightlifting. But for the most part, he's just dancing. And he's having the best time.
Good for him.
And it puts me in a good mood.
I would feel self-conscious to just do that.
Although it's weird, though, when, like, when I've been at, like, a bench next to the guy, because then I'm like, should I dance with him? Like, yeah, I mean, like, it's kind of...
Well, I mean, it's a party.
I just kind of get into it.
Yeah, I'm just saying, but you're going to have to shut your iPhone off because you're not going to know what the hell.
I'll have to ask him what he's listening to, and I'll be like, all right, to count of three, we'll hit play at the same time.
Oh, sync it up, look at that. That's dance fancy.
Off. Dance off.
It might be a silent dance-off, which would be the best part, because anyone else who walks in just sees you, two guys just dancing with each other.
Just stepping no at music, each other.
Today's podcast was brought to you by Travis Gagne, bankruptcy attorney. Here's another question from a listener. How long is a bankruptcy going to affect my credit rating?
Of course, most of the time, by the time
we're talking about filing a bankruptcy, the credit has already taken a huge hit. Chapter 7 is going to affect it more negatively than Chapter 13. Chapter 7 stays on your credit report for 10 years from the time you file. It usually takes 7 or 8 years for your credit scores to get back into the normal range in a Chapter 7 case. However, your credit will start to recover even in Chapter 7 after about a year. You'll be able to get credit again right away, usually before your case is even over. Chapter 13 stays on your credit report for 7 years and usually takes about 3 to 3.5 years for your credit to get back in the normal range. So Chapter 13 will mean your credit gets better much more rapidly.
Thanks, Travis. If you have more questions about bankruptcy, you can reach out to Travis anytime at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com. Thanks for listening.